Welcome to another video from PacificStyle.com. I hope you guys are ready for this one. This is going to be quite a long one, so I'm probably going to cut it into two parts. And as you can probably tell from the title, it's another discovery series. And this one is on Essence, which is a German brand. Excuse my hair today. I've had a long day. This is actually the first time I'm filming at night, but I really needed to get this video done, and it's fall now here in Switzerland, so we're getting much less daylight time, and much less hours in the day in terms of daylight. And so I had to film at night, so I hope it'll work out. Anyway, Essence is definitely, for me, the cheapest brand I've found here in Europe. Cheapest European brand, right? And the reason I'm featuring it on this discovery is they have quite some good products. They have quite a huge selection. They're affordable, they're all under 10 francs. And from what I've seen on the net, for people that have bought in the US, it's also been under $10 as well. And here, the most expensive Essence product I've seen, which is a mousse foundation, was 720 francs, right? But otherwise, everything is between the range of 3 to 5 francs. So for us, that is really, really affordable, right? So I thought it would be helpful to make this series, especially for the islanders that are this side and are looking for something they can use that's affordable but don't want to have to fork out so much money for the high-end stuff all the time, okay? So just to give you more options and basically to introduce to everyone out there what Essence is like. Certain stuff I will talk about a bit more if I really like them, and the rest I'll sort of run through. And if you would like to know more about something or would like me to make a video specifically for that, you can let me know. Write in below or email us at Pacific Style. But for the sake of time, I'm just going to kind of run through everything, so I hope it's okay with you guys. So the first one is this Essence Pure Skin Pure Taint. T-E-I-N-T. I'm going to pronounce it taint, okay? So it's Essence Pure Taint Matte Bronzing Powder, okay? That's what it looks like. I hope you can see it and that the camera is not making it look freaky or too reflective. I currently have a MAC powder and also a Revlon one that I use just to after I've applied foundation, that I use it to set the foundation, or simply on days when I feel I'm a bit too shiny or greasy, I like to use a bit of powder to soak up the shine and the grease. Yeah. Anyway, and I prefer the Revlon one, which is the color stay one, and I had been using that, but I hit pan on that, so it's almost finished, so I had to start looking for a different alternative, something to replace that. And then the thing is, here, as most islanders, if you've gone makeup shopping, depending on where you are, will know that there is not much of a shade selection. Like most foundations from Maybelline and L'Oreal and whatnot that they have here, come in either 4 or 5 shades, okay? And I know that's not the full shade selection, because they're in the US, they have more, right? But here they have only 4 or 5, and most of the time you hardly find a dark shade, So it is really hard to get colors that suit darker skin tones, and especially island skin tones. And also, even if you do, I have seen some that are dark, but it was either too dark or it has that white or grayish, how do you describe it, the undertone. And for me and a lot of islanders, we don't have that white or gray undertone to our skin. We have something it's sort of golden or yellowish. Yeah, that undertone, And if you put on products with the wrong undertone, it looks mask-like. You can see that it doesn't go with the rest of your skin. So it's really, really hard to not only get the right shade for islanders, but also the right undertone to products. And here I've only seen two brands that gave that proper undertone, which is MAC and Bobbi Brown. And everywhere, MAC and Bobbi Brown are not cheap, right? So that's why I was really, really happy about finding this essence powder, because I don't know if it shows up that way on camera, right? But it is like a really bronzy color. And it goes perfectly onto my skin. And what I love about this powder, it's so fine. And I don't like my skin too covered, right? And I like the shine to be reduced, but I don't want things completely matte and no glow anywhere. I just don't like that personally, you know? It works for other people, but for me, I don't like it. So that's what's great about this powder for me, is that I use a kabuki brush and I just, you know, swirl it in there and dust it all over my face. And it will, like, remove the shine, but I still see my skin. I'm not having my skin covered up in this cakey mess, and I really don't like that. So I'm really happy with this powder. And I will do, I think, a more in-depth review with this, comparing it with some other powders, okay? But I can tell you now, I love this, and I've been using this since I bought it like 3 weeks ago. I've just been using this straight, and I have to remind myself to finish off my other powders, but I've been so happy with this one. And also, that's another thing for you islanders distributed everywhere in the world. If you're struggling to find products that go with your skin tone, or, you know, that work for you, keep an open mind and don't always go with what the label says. Like, for example, this says a matte bronzing powder, right? And on fair skin, it would give them some color and dimension to their face, so it would serve that bronzing purpose, right? But us islanders don't need to be bronze or tanned, because you're already got color, you know. And I don't use this for a bronzing purpose. I use it as a face powder, even though it's a bronzing powder. So just keep an open mind like that, especially in places where there's not quite a wide selection. And especially us being kind of different in our skin tones and skin color and whatnot, you know, we have to work a little bit harder to find stuff that works for us. So it's just a tip for you guys to keep an open mind and experiment a bit. So that's the essence powder I have, and the one I've got is in light bronze. I didn't see any darker color. I don't know if it comes in a darker color, but if you're my skin tone, a little bit lighter and a couple shades darker, you could still carry this off as a face powder to remove shine, but not completely clog up your face. I've talked long enough about this, but it just so happens that I really like it, and I was excited about it because it's something I could recommend to other islanders in this part of the world that are looking for, you know, products like that. So I found something within our shade range. Anyway, so we'll move on, and I'll just quickly run through some of the other stuff. These are what the eyeshadows look like. I bought this a long time ago. This is the Quattro eyeshadow. I think they still have it. I bought it like last year or 2 years ago even. But anyway, it's 4 eyeshadows there. It's number 3 and it's called It Beats the Sun. Okay, I'll open it up. Okay, so you got the 4 colors in there. I got it because I needed this blue, but I turned up to really like this brown, which is why it's the most used one. With a lot of Essence eyeshadows, it's a little bit hit and miss. You know, sometimes you get one that's really pigmented, and then other times you'll get one that you have to work a little bit harder with. But this one, like, I'll show you the brown. I will swatch it for you. Okay, I hope you can see that. So it's a lovely shimmery brown. I really like it for quick swipe of eyeshadow, and this one's a nice color too. Okay, and then if I show you the blue, okay, it's not as pigmented as the brown, if you'll see. but you're getting color, and hey, you pay like $3-$4 or something, you can't complain too much, but they give you a decent pigmentation, some more than other shades. They also have, from their Sun Club range, they have this one, round one. I think they still make these. They have another color selection, but that's what it looks like inside. We've got five shadows in there. And then they also have them in singles, like this. And this is my favorite blending eyeshadow. I was looking for an eyeshadow to blend with, you know, sometimes, especially with dark colors, and you need to blend it out so you don't have a harsh line. I like to use an eyeshadow to do that, but that doesn't really show up on my skin. And most importantly, that doesn't show up as white. I really don't like highlights or blending colors that are too white, because it just doesn't go with my skin tone, and it stands out, and I don't often like it. Like, with certain looks, okay, but most of the looks, no. So this is an off-white. It's number 22, called Blockbuster Matte Effect. It is matte eyeshadow. And then they also have these marbleized shadows. My Essence Color and Shine looks like that. And this is sort of a chocolate brown with like cream color all swirled in there. Okay, if you can see that. And it's very shimmery, so if you don't like shimmer, then might not be your thing. And you could use it wet or dry. And this is actually the color I have on today, which I'll get closer to the camera so you can see it. I hope you can see it, otherwise I'll look probably really funny doing this. They also have like duos, which are, they call smoky eye sets, that look like this, right? And it comes with the sort of the instructions on the back of how you're supposed to use them, and it's in English, okay? So for those of you that don't speak German, it's in English. It's shimmery, it's not matte, okay? So I know a lot of people might prefer the powder to be matte. Like I said, it's shimmery, it's not really a true black, it's more like a shimmery gray, charcoal gray. And the liner is not like intense. Oh, it comes with an applicator, okay? Sponge applicator and a sort of blunt edge brush at the bottom. Move on to the next one. This is from another one from the Sun Club collection. It's shimmer strips, you know. I think a lot of companies make these ones, like these Physicians Formula, the famous ones are the Bobbi Brown ones. I really, really like this. This, they come in two types. One is for brunettes and darker skin, and one is for fairer skin and blondes. The thing is, I don't know if this is available anymore. It might be wherever, in certain places, still be there, because I think they've come up with a new one, because I went to look for another one like this and I couldn't find it, and in its place I saw another palette. So it's possible they've redone it, which I'm quite disappointed about. Well, I've broken this one. That's me. I'm always breaking stuff. But I don't know if the camera picks this up, but do you see how beautiful those colors are? And they're so, so beautiful on island skin. And if I swatch it, like, I'll pick up this. This is one of my favorite browns. Like, it's just a beautiful, beautiful bronze color. I hope you can see that. So, so beautiful. I don't know, like I said, I don't know if it's still available, but this is a multi-purpose product. I've used it to like lighten up my, to brighten up my cheeks. Use it, you can use it as a highlight, especially for us island skin tones, this just goes so well. And but you can also use the strips as eyeshadows, okay? So multi-purpose product, goes really, really well with island skin tone, and this is a lovely highlight, shimmery highlight color.